The impact of large language models on the way we work and process information is undeniable. But like with any other tools, to reap maximum benefits, it is crucial to know how to utilize them efficiently. In the same way, the Industrial Revolution forever changed how we perform physical labor, we are now experiencing a transformation in the way we approach mental tasks. A single skilled prompt engineer can replace 10 experts in certain fields, which is why some companies are already offering up to $335K for this job. And with the pace of AI revolution being much faster, it is even more crucial not to fall behind. So in this video, let me share with you 3 advanced prompt engineering techniques that I have discovered in over my 3 years of experience working with large language models to help you become more effective and stay ahead of the curve in this rapidly changing landscape. Let's get started. Number 1. Provide examples. I cannot stress this enough. Large language models do not technically reason. They look at your text as a whole, thanks to the self-attention mechanisms called transformers, and they simply try to predict the next word. That's it. For example, if you want the model to predict the next word in a sentence like "I went to the store and bought something," it won't reason about what you typically buy. Instead, it looks at the pattern of words and guesses the most likely word to come next based on its training data. This leads to results completely unrelated to your own use case. However, if you provide examples up front, such as "I went to the store and bought a shirt" or "I went to the store and bought a hoodie," the model will predict the next word related to clothing. GPT-3's groundbreaking paper, "Large Language Models Are Few-Shot Learners," highlights that pre-trained LLMs can make accurate predictions after only a few examples. It's like giving the model a crash course, allowing it to quickly learn and generalize to new scenarios. But now that ChatGPT is out and GPT-3 is not used as often, how can you take advantage of this technique? Here is a quick guide. Visit Platform OpenAI Playground and select Chat Mode. Define your system message. To generate an article similar to one you've written before, extract key parameters like the title and main points and paste them as a user message. Paste the article itself as the assistant message, showing the model what the ideal output should be for the parameters that you define. Create new parameters for your next article, paste them as a user message and click submit. The model will now generate an article closely resembling the example you provided. Describing the task to make the model generate an article as close to your own as this one would take hours without any prior examples. And the best part is that the more examples you provide, the better the outcome will be. So remember to always supply the model with clear examples when possible. And if you don't have enough examples, stay tuned until the end for a workaround technique. Number 2. Chain requests. Chaining is the process of combining multiple prompts where each subsequent prompt is based on the output of the previous one. This powerful technique enables large language models to perform more complex tasks such as generating long text, summarizing books, or extracting context for a better response. To harness the full potential of chaining, consider automating the process using the OpenAI API. Here are some examples to illustrate how chaining can be used to solve specific problems. Once I needed to create an application that would generate queries in Adobe's profile query language, which ChatGPT and Codex are not familiar with. To overcome this issue, I employed chaining with multiple requests. The first request asked ChatGPT to identify essential parts of the documentation for a given query. Next, I asked ChatGPT which functions were required from these parts of documentation. And finally, I extracted only the parts of documentation for these functions and used it as a context in the final prompt. This allowed me to include all the necessary information from Adobe's documentation to convert natural language into a specific profile language query without hitting the token limit, and the results were quite impressive. Chaining can also be used to summarize lengthy texts that far exceed the token limit. The whole approach was described in one of OpenAI's blog posts. If you're interested in a more in-depth tutorial on this, let me know in the comments. All in all, chaining provides a versatile approach to performing a wide range of tasks with large language models. While it might take some practice to master, understanding when to use chaining and when to use other methods enables you to fully harness the capabilities of these powerful tools. Number 3. Think step by step. One last technique that helps unlock the full potential of large language models is the chain of thought method. Although these models don't inherently excel at critical thinking, you can enhance their performance by guiding them through a step-by-step thought process. This approach is similar to how we typically think before speaking. Consider this problem posed to GPT-3. I went to the market and bought 10 apples. I gave 2 apples to the neighbor and 2 to the repairman. I then went and bought 5 more apples and ate one. How many apples did I remain with? Surprise Surprisingly, the model incorrectly answers 11 apples. Now, why can't a model with 175 billion parameters costing millions to train solve such a simple math problem? My guess is that because GPT-3 encodes all human knowledge, it encodes our mistakes as well. To address this limitation, we can simply add the phrase "let's think step by step." This way, the model outlines all the necessary steps, ultimately leading to the correct answer. 10 apples. Interestingly, for this particular problem, ChatGPT reasons step by step by default and returns the correct answer on a first attempt. Since the chain of thought concept was introduced somewhere between the release of GPT-3 and ChatGPT, it's possible that OpenAI has already somehow integrated it into newer models. Regardless, this technique is invaluable for complex tasks. So here's another example of how to apply the chain of thought technique in practice. Suppose you're considering whether to buy a new laptop or upgrade your current one. You can ask ChatGPT the following question: should I buy a new laptop or upgrade my current one? Let's think step by step. With the chain of thought prompt, the model is more likely to provide a thoughtful and comprehensive analysis. It might respond with: assess the current state of your laptop, determine your needs and requirements, compare costs, weigh the pros and cons, and finally make a decision. By using the chain of thought technique, you encourage the model to think more systematically, providing a clearer and more reasoned response to help you make an informed decision. Simply add "let's think step by step" at the end of your prompt and witness the magic unfold. In summary, to become a pro in prompt engineering, always provide examples, chain requests, and encourage the model to think step by step. Experimenting with these methods will open doors to new possibilities and allow you to stay ahead of the curve in this exciting and ever-changing space. And like always, if you want to know more about how to leverage the power of AI, don't forget to subscribe.